Dylan in his fifth over. Man of the match in the Barbados game, of Dylan. Oh, that's a very good bouncer. That is very good bouncer and equally well played, or well left, by Rahul Dravid.
Yeah, it wasn't quite straight enough. Just needed it to be straighter. And you just don't see pitches like this in India. That's all. Played. That will probably go all the way. Just slowing up, gets in this lush grass, but it was a nice shot. Once it up, just play straight through the line of the ball. You don't have to hit it hard. You only get four when it gets to the boundary. If you hit it harder and it goes there quicker, you don't get 10 because it gets there quicker. Just play the shot properly. I come back to that point. It's so important that India bat well today. If they do, if they get blown away, poor feeling off his own bowling, then they'll be chasing the game, just like they were in Barbados, even if they're all out for 160 or 70. And it really is a test of their character and determination. Whoa, whoa, what a good shot. Just took the ball at the top of its bounce. Didn't try to hit it too hard, so you use the pace of the delivery. And you've got a bit of width. That's a corker of a shot.
Yes, it is. And he's placed it well, too. There is a fielder at cover point. There's a wide-ish gully. He's placed it between those two fielders. He placed that shot well. Nicely played. And this is poor effort from Pedro Collins.
Come back, come back, come back.
Well, usually bowlers are very, very good off their own bowling because they know that the runs go against their bowling analysis, which is the second time in 10 or 15 minutes that he's actually missed the ball.
He's getting onto the front foot well is Wasim Jaffer. Not much of a slope down that area. It's the opposite end that the big slope is on.
Yes, I had a chat. Just having a look at Brian, having a little stretch there, a little think as well. I had a chat with him at practice yesterday, and he was telling me how frustrating he felt not being able to time the ball as well as he can. But I said to him that you should be careful that you've been out of cricket quite some time. You've got to take some time to work your way back.
They'll run away for a couple as well.
Tosses.
Ooh, inside edge, that saved him. But he had a long stride too. 37 for one. Looking for a shot on the offside, and he'd still pick up a couple. That's the way the game goes sometimes.
Yes, we see. I'll have a look at the Antiguan and Barbudan flag there. It's a flag which I've grown accustomed to over the years, and I'm quite certain you'd feel the way whenever you see the Indian flag that there's a little lump in your throat, and sometimes the goose pimples come around. My flag is the symbol of the way I feel sometimes.
What a good shot that is. Oh, he's in good form, this young man. That was a superb shot.
After we were talking about flags and all that sort of stuff, we were missing that, and that's a brilliant shot. Yeah, wow, who needs to see flag when you can play shots like that? Brilliant.
Oh, that's not very well done. They'll get a second. Oh, Frederick Collins is not having the best of times down on the outfield. Don't see that happening too often.
Yes, looking at this particular replay, I think this is rather poor cricket. He got himself behind it. Yes, I think Pedro Collins have had some problems over the years, not having been one of the better fieldsmen in West Indian cricket. I think he's a fine bowler, but I think he needs to improve a little bit more, because there are times where I see him drop some very crucial catches.
Four more. He does like the bowling of Pedro Collins, as Wasim Jaffer. First back foot and now front foot. He does like that width outside off stump, and certainly so far he's kept the ball down.
Yes, looking at the replay here, I think that was a rather wide half volley, and I think Jaffer, especially for the time that he's been in, said to himself, I wasn't going to miss out on this particular opportunity, scoring some runs there, and he did it in fine fashion.
...34 not out. India bring up 50 with a fine shot from Wasim Jaffer. No. It's looking in very good nick. So they'll all be watching back home in Mumbai, where there'd been a clamour for his inclusion in the national side. Now watch just after he plays the shot. There he goes, down on the knee. And that is, there you are, that is a beautiful still. If you ever wanted to take one, just looks so composed and looked very good. And we get more runs. Another boundary, this time just opening the face of the bat.
Looking at this replay, you can see he just waited for the ball to come on, used the pace of Pedro Collins and just angled the bat, knew to himself that there wasn't a third man, but there was a big gap between third slip and gully, and that was saying four from the moment it left the bat.
They are very similar figures to this in the second innings at Barbados. Wasim Jaffer preferring that square area. Throwing the bowling of Collins as well, 54 for one.
Lovely shot down the ground. No need to run for that. That's the seventh boundary for Wasim Jaffer. That'll end the over. 56 for one. Very positive in his mindset. He's looking to put the bad ball away. This was overpitched and it got the treatment. Good balance when he plays it, offering the full face of the plate when he punched it down the ground. Good stop. There was no third man, so some runs saved here for the West Indies.
Sneak single, that's all you'll get. 61 for one.
That was a really good call, was that? Wasn't a great throw, but it was a good call and a correct one.
I think it's a very good call, because now Wavell Hines was the fielder running towards the ball. Remember, Wavell Hines bats left-handed. It's important to know which hand he throws with. That's punched down the ground. Might just reach the boundary. In fact, beats Dillon. That's a shot he plays well, Dravid. So the 50 partnership comes up with that boundary. Now this was Wavell Hines. It was a good call, the previous ball from Jaffer, sending him back because Dravid wanted the single. At times, as a batsman, you might think because the batsman's left-handed, his throwing arm is left-handed. But Jaffer was right, because he throws right-handed, it was going towards the direction of the throwing arm. So, good call. Again, opening the face of the blade. That was intentional. There's no third man, so another boundary here for Jaffer. And the Indians going along nicely at this stage.
Well, they've threatened to get one through that gap. You know, the last over, a couple of good saves from the slips, in particular Gales. This one right in the middle of gully and the three slips. And I think you have to give credit to the bat. I think he deliberately opened the face there. A little dangerous maybe, but maybe he feels so comfortable now that he's in with 40-odd not out.
Yes, but not carrying. Just not carrying to Brian Lara. And the question to be asked was, could Jacobs have gone across?
Well, I just said it's dangerous to be opening the face of the bat. You got one through the gully area, through opening the bat, but it's not a smart idea. And here he is, good line, good length. You see, the bat's slightly open. It's not pointing right down the middle. It's just open there, and he's late with his back foot getting across. And he's a very, very lucky man that that didn't carry.
It's cut away, that was sweetly timed, but he can't find the gap. So the Indians going to lunch, 73 for one.